Fans, introducing, weighing in at 227 pounds from Nashville, Tennessee, Reno Riggins. His opponent making his way to the ring area with 250 pounds from Atlanta, Georgia, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. He's accompanied to the ring by the Dirty White Boy and Mr. Ron Wright.
All right, and Dutch, of course, that's a collaboration that we've seen in recent weeks here, the Dirty White Boy and Paul Orndorff. And, of course, that's because that they are going to be teamed together to face Tim Horner and Ronnie Garvin at Christmas Chaos. So they've been sort of inseparable. That's the Dirty White Boy and of course, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. But Orndorff in the ring right now against Reno Riggins.
Well, first of all, we've had a mistake by Brian Matthews, our incomparable ring announcer, when he said that Reno Riggins is from Nashville, Tennessee. Actually, he's from Las Vegas, Nevada, one of my favorite towns in the whole country. And he's made a couple of appearances here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and yet his one-loss record is not too good. But he is a very talented young man. But I think he is overmatched today when he gets in the ring with Paul Orndorff, because Paul Orndorff, you see right there, he has been all over the world. He's an international star. He has challenged all the other champions and all the other federations for a championship match. Recently, WCW has been down there challenging those people. So, as you can see, he's a very, very busy man in the world of professional wrestling as of today.
Well, he's been busy, Dutch, and as you said, he's challenged a number of champions around the world, as well as having held a number of championships, and now here is Riggins down into the corner. Orndorff makes no attempt to hide it at all, just puts both big hands right around the throat and just choking away at him. You know, the White Boy outside of the ring there with Ron Wright is just
the White Boy who last week had a belt stolen from him.
He's beside himself about Tim Horner taking that
belt. Well, he's a thief. He's a thief.
Last week, Bob Armstrong asked Horner to bring it back, but he hasn't done that as of yet, Dutch. Horner still has that championship belt.
Okay, what was the decision on that? He didn't win, did he? But yet at the same time, oh, wait a minute, Riggins may get a win right here. Nope. Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff made almost a crucial mistake right there and almost paid for it with a loss right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Orndorff goes down. He cut a backward flip. You know, you talked about him having challenged a number of champions around the world. How do you think it sits with him now teaming and being a partner of the Smoky Mountain champion, the Dirty White Boy?
Well, if titles is his main agenda, then it might be very interesting in the next couple of months if the White Boy does indeed hold on to the title, which he is the champion. White Boy is the Smoky Mountain heavyweight champion.
Right.
But Tim Horner has
Horner's got the belt.
Yeah, but he's a thief, and it's easy to steal something.
What is this about possession being 90% of the law?
Well, in Tim Horner's case, it's 100% of the law because he still has it now. Bob Armstrong asked him to bring the belt back, but what does he do? Completely ignore the commissioner, and he's still hanging on to it. That, to me, is a violation of ethics, of rules, of regulations, of morals, a violation of everything that you could possibly wish to put on it. And I think he should be fined extensively, at least $2,000.
Riggins again coming off of the ropes. Orndorff with that good leg takedown.
Oh, good move by Orndorff and a good counter move by Riggins.
It is, and Riggins is showing you a lot of wrestling ability. He's got a lot of athletic skills.
Let me say one thing
there,
about Reno Riggins. I think with just maybe a little more proper guidance, see, he needs to get a different attitude about the profession, and I think he may make some inroads.
Now, what kind of attitude are we talking about?
Well, he needs to listen to me just a little bit, and I can tell him how to win some matches.
How would that be, Dutch?
Well, first of all, don't get in the ring with Paul Orndorff in this stage of his career.
Oh, there's that elbow.
Oh, here's man,
Orndorff
right.
Again with that elbow. That one caught him high on the head. And Riggins goes down on one knee. And Orndorff just measures him again for that elbow.
Did I say on Down and Dirty with Dutch, I'm going to talk to Tim Horner?
Yeah, you
I'm
did.
I'm going to talk to White Lightning, yep. Tim Horner, and I'm going to get his reasons for stealing a belt. Do you think he has a reason? Does he
I
have
think
an
he
excuse?
Probably got a really good reason.
Well, we will find out. Fans, stay tuned. Down and Dirty with Dutch, my special guest, Tim Horner, today. And he's going to answer a few hardcore questions from me.
Orndorff high under the ropes that time, using the ropes for a little extra leverage, got high in the air, came right down with that knee as Riggins is over in the corner, still flat on his back. And he has been taking a pounding in the last several minutes of this match from Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff. But Orndorff missed that drop kick.
Ooh.
He got high in the air, and Riggins held a rope, and there was nowhere for Orndorff to go with it. And they stand there toe-to-toe slugging it out. And it looks like Orndorff is the one that's going to give ground.
Oh!
It's Riggins with a drop kick.
Well, I tell you, this Riggins is more than held his own here against Mr. Wonderful here. I hope he doesn't make a mistake, because
the reversal on that whip, and Riggins over the ropes.
Down,
he's onto the top rope, into the corner.
Oh,
flying cross,
beautiful dive. Wait a minute. Orndorff goes through. And he gets the win.
Well, when it looked like it was going to go the other way, Dutch, I think the experience factor really paid off for Paul Orndorff.
Well, the experience factor certainly proved true for Paul Orndorff. He rode. Let's take a look at it, fans. Here it comes right here. You see Orndorff. He shoots Riggins in over the top rope. Now, Paul makes a strategic mistake. He turns his back on Riggins. Riggins, a big, high, beautiful crossbody block. But you see Orndorff, from experience, rose right through it, comes right around, maybe a little bit of touch. But irregardless, Paul Orndorff victorious over Reno Riggins. Let's go right now to Bob Collins standing by with a dirty white boy and Paul Orndorff right now.
All right, Dutch, and right you are. Here is Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, the dirty white boy, Mr. Ron Wright. And I tell you, you two are going to be teamed together. We got tag team action at Christmas Chaos against Ronnie Garvin. And what is this? He wants his belt.
That's
he wants
exactly
his belt.
What
is that what you're saying?
That's exactly what he's saying. They took the belt and they won't give it back to them. We're needing to get Bob Armstrong and get some kind of something ruled and get our title back where it belongs.
You never find Bob Armstrong when you need him. I want my belt back. There's a thief in Smoky Mountain, and his name is White Lightning Tim Horner. Speaking of belt,
and here he is.
I wanted to see
Commissioner Bob Armstrong.
We know who he is. I want my belt back, and I want my belt right now. So do something about it. You're the man. You're the commissioner. So give me my belt.
Let me just say this. I've looked for the belt. I cannot find the belt. I asked Tim Horner. He does not know where the belt is. But I'll tell you what. I've tried to have a single match with you guys, see who the best man is, and give it to the best man. But I'll tell you what. Since Christmas Chaos is coming and you guys have a tag match, I'm going to put your belt up in that tag match. How about that?
No, you can't do that. That's not like a handicap match. Two men against one. Huh? What do they have to lose? I've got everything to lose.
Okay.
You're a fair man.
Okay.
Come on, you're right.
All right, you're right. You have a point. I'm going to do the right thing.
There you go.
Since it's a tag team match, I'm just going to put your belt up the first 30 minutes of that match.
The first 30 minutes?
Hey! Tim Horner! Ronnie Garvin! You're a T-H-I-E-S! Do you know what that spells? That's exactly right! Oh, you stupid, illiterate rednecks out there! Don't even know how to spell your own name! You bunch of morons! Myself and Dirty White Boy! I want my robe back! He wants his belt back! We want our belt back!
It comes down at Christmas Chaos! We'll be back!
We want my robe!
We want my belt!
He wants my belt! He wants it back! Yes! Yes!